Now it's Tannehill. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down. Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 39. Give them 22 there on the third down conversion. So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that third down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field. Defensively, make sure you know where he is because he understands how to get open in key situations.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Second quarter now, Titans in possession of the football as they've got it with second down and less than a yard. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first. Now Tannehill. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
So it looks like they stopped some fighting them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But this defense gets two more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
Tannehill's throw pulled in by Hopkins. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And Henry fighting for the marker, but I don't think he got there. He did not. That'll be marked inches short. No gain on the play, and that's going to lead him to fourth down. Remember, that was less than a yard. That was not a full yard. That defense, they were having none of it.
Yeah, the surge offensive line was seeking actually occurred on the other side of the ball. They reestablished the line of scrimmage and stuffed them.
So both teams come away with points on their opening drives. Now they still trail. They answered the touchdown with a field goal, but at least able to break that goose egg here early.
And that is what's important, right? Because they didn't let that initial touchdown go unanswered. Took the ball themselves, moved it downfield, and put it through the post for 3 points. Game on.
Their quarterback in this offense heading back out to the field. He was a perfect 7 of 7 on that opening drive, the 7th being the touchdown pass. And they'll start here with a 1st and 10. Hall. And his throw's going to be incomplete. As we thought they might do here in week 2 of the preseason, they'd left their starting quarterback out there for this second quarter, but I would imagine we will not see him after halftime.
Yeah, this is the time of year you've got to get your backup some reps and make sure you protect your starting quarterback.
Another throw on 2nd down, and this one incomplete as well. The Vikings on 3rd down, a perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is 3rd and 10. Flushed out right, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game. So on 4th down, Ryan Wright on to punt for Minnesota. Returning it is Moore. A 46-yard punt, 8 yards on the return. And it'll be Titan football. The Titans coming back onto the field for their 2nd drive. And a methodical drive last time, but they couldn't get that knockout blow. They had to settle for 3.
But you got to like what they've been doing along the way, right? It's almost like the body blow is the setup punch. As you said, they didn't get the knockout blow here, but that doesn't mean it can't come later in the game on another possession. And the defense on the other side.
Maybe a little gas,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, a little tired. And if nothing else, they just feel relieved getting upfield only giving up 3. They don't exactly feel like they've handled the offense.
Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's 2nd down. Here's Tannehill. He's got Derrick Henry again, back-to-back catches. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. And the line to gain here is the 37 on third down. Now a play fake, and it's Tannehill. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Byron Murphy. And the Vikings are going to get this back to their own 34-yard line. Well, look, we're watching a quarterback here that's obviously been around for a long time. That's a throw he wishes he had back.
He certainly does, but as you well know, this is a guy that's used to taking a few chances, used to fitting it into tight windows. These are throws that he's made before. Didn't happen to get it completed in this case.
And now out comes Minnesota. As we eat closer and closer to intermission, Charles, remember last time out they punted. They would love to get points here, especially if this is going to be their final possession of the first half.
Yeah, and this is what close games feel like, because the pressure is on both sides, but sometimes the pressure is a little bit higher on the team with the slight edge, because they're trying to hold on to that, trying to increase it. Let's see how this one continues.
And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. Here's second and three. Here's Hall. And he fires one incomplete. You know, during these preseason games, we're in week two right now, it's always funny looking at our spot charts up here in the booth, because with all the guys that might play in this one, it seems to get bigger and bigger each year.
Yeah, we pretty much supersize them, don't we? Because, you know, remember, they're carrying 90 now. And with the new rules, they'll carry 90 all the way through the preseason before they make the final cut. Oh, yeah, a lot of guys to learn for these games.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Here's Hall. Complete. Jefferson the target. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. Paul to throw it. Play for Justin Jefferson. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. Another first down as he went right back to the same well, this time for 17 yards.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down the field. And just like that, they're going to be set up with a first and goal.
Back to throw, Hall. And a dangerous throw there, incomplete. He threw that into coverage. It was nearly intercepted. They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's second and goal now. Now Hall. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. Now Hall, going to throw on third and goal. Forced out to his left. He'll wind up getting 4 yards there on his own, but it also brings up fourth down. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. The kick by Joseph is good. So 3 points on the board, as easy a field goal as you're going to get, but I can see you shaking your head.
I love that peripheral vision of yours, partner, because to me, if it's the fourth quarter and you're up 6, I get it. But now, even if you run and don't get in, you're still setting them up to go a long field, 98, 99-yard drive. How do you look at your defense and not give them that opportunity?
So we've reached halftime here in Minnesota with the Vikings on top. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thank you very much. We'll get back to you and Charles in just a minute. Week 2 of the preseason is upon us. Each team now with just one more game after this one. And then we will get it all started as we normally do on the first Thursday after Labor Day. In our game, the defenses look to be ready for the regular season. Maybe not the offenses just yet.
And
but
we
still
will
have
not
to
see
go.
Turn to start
as we
the
get
half,
back
this
out
be a touch
to Brandon Gott.
Out come the Titans now. They'll have it first on offense to start the third. And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive, because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air.
Here's a second and two now from the 33. Off the play fake, Levis. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down. After the incompletion, here now, third and two. Out of the gun again with Spears. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short.
Another down on the scoreboard, but the urge to go for it is almost irresistible here on fourth and short. Yeah, I know. I know they're on their own side of the field.
I was going to say.
Normally, I would say punt the ball away, but I'm feeling it. I say go for it.
Here's Ryan Stonehouse now as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. Fielded at the 20. They'll net only 35 here following a 43-yard boot, 8-yard return.
And they will take over first and 10.
It's the Vikings' turn on offense. We get ready for their first possession of the second half. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
And a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back.
No, bottled up, fumble. It's out, it's loose. It's picked up by the Titans. And they will take over at the 29-yard line.
You know, if this is the regular season, partner, we'd be talking about just how costly a mistake that was, but probably good for him to get it out of his system right now.
Just hope for him and the team it's not a sign of things to come.
Yeah, without a doubt. Plus, you got to worry about making the team. Those types of errors don't help you.
Here's Tennessee ready to begin this drive offensively. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure. Now, the question, was the knee, in fact, down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of the football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. Throwing on third down, Fields. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
So much of this game is focus and concentration. And whenever I see guys running the in route, I know that in the back of their mind, they're always wondering who's lurking inside that might put a big hit on them as they try and catch the ball.
Pulled in at the 24. So a change of possession here on the punt. And that will come the offense as they take over. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now what you're looking for is can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive.
That's complete to Westbrook Akine.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
They show run with three tight ends here on first down.
Hand off to Spears. And he'll be taken down at about the 45.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Alexander Johnson. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory. And he's a high draft pick, so maybe a bit of a mulligan, but you never want to throw a preseason interception, especially as a rookie.
No, but this is the time to do it, right? Let's get the kinks out. He's still got to learn how to read coverages, still has to learn the entire offense, has to see how he fits with the players around him. But bottom line is what you said right in the beginning. He's a high draft pick. They want him on the field sooner rather than later, so let's keep giving him some reps and seeing what they have.
They go over the middle, and it's complete to start the drive. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
From the 42-yard line, here's a second and five. Here's Fields.
Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Lambert. First target, first catch, and a first down.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Fields.
And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down.
Monty Rice, he's the culprit, dropping him for a 2-yard loss. They've got second and 12 from the 36. Fields now to throw.
Under pressure, and they got to him again.
Multiple players getting home there for an 8-yard loss.
Well, that was an interesting little chess match there because the offense went empty set. No running backs in the backfield, so they're trying to get people out into a route pretty quickly. But guess what? The defense sees that. They go ahead and move themselves into a blitzing situation and come right after the quarterback. They had more guys there than they could block.
On the draw, it's Nwanger.
And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 16, but they'll remain short of the marker, and it's fourth down. And the attempt at three will have to come from the other end of the field as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more preseason football on EA Sports. And we return welcoming you back to Minneapolis. It's the Vikings in possession of the football and the lead. They'll be looking to add to that total as we begin quarter number four.
So that CD, an important one here in the fourth quarter.
And that importance cannot be overstated. On both sidelines, we're staring that one down all the way. The significance is that they made it a two-score game. Still lots of time left to go, but likely that was their goal at the start of the drive. Get 3 points, make it a two-score game, and they were able to get it done.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive.
That's to the tight end, Wiley.
And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and 3.
Levis from the gun. Open man, Westbrook Akine.
6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown.
A throw over the middle, taken in.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That one good for a pickup of 15 for Tennessee.
Well, every drive from here out is definitely crucial and critical. They know that they need to get at least 3 here to get it back to a one-score game. But I can't imagine that in their huddle that they're thinking at all about getting a field goal. They want to get into the end zone and then try and get the ball back again.
From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10 at the 47. This is caught inside the 15. And it's a Titans touchdown. A great play there. 47 yards.
And the Titans have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. And what a throw that was, Charles. You think about the situation. Close game, fourth quarter, rookie quarterback. He doesn't seem phased one bit.
So much for bright lights, big city, and will he wilt? Not at all. The stage not too big, the moment not too big at all. They needed points on that series, and not only did he produce a touchdown drive, but how about finishing it off with a big play that only adds to the momentum that they've already established.
The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line.
The Vikings offense now heading out to take over. That last touchdown has made this really tight. They're clinging now to this slim lead. Second half, they only have a field goal. This offense needs to kick it into gear.
And right now, I'm looking directly at the field general, at the quarterback. Because to me, he's got to take over right now by word, pumping his team up, and then, of course, by deed with his play. My high school coach used to say that all the time. Laddie, take over by word and deed.
And deed means action.
Exactly.
The Vikings on third down. They're at 50%, 4 for 8. This will be 3rd and 5. Now it's Fields. That is caught. And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that certainly appears to be a critical conversion right there, because not only do they keep the drive going, they take valuable time off the clock as well. They have to feel really good about that last completion.
A play fake, now Fields to throw. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up 2nd down. Out of the gun, Fields. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now 3rd down. Here's Fields. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Oliver. And they will advance this across midfield, but still well shy of a first as he's tackled at the 47. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And it'll be 4th down. So they're forced to punt on 4th as this one's away. So Levis and the Titans now down 13-10. A little under 2.5 to go. You can't say the preseason isn't interesting. This has been great as they come up 1st and 10. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. Three points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They come up on a 2nd down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down the wire. Meanwhile, Levis's throw hauled in by Westbrook Akine here. That's what they need right now. Get the 1st down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
Plenty of time. All 3 timeouts still remain. Here's 1st and 10 now. Levis to throw. Able to find Dowell. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Haven't heard much from him all night, but welcome to the party, making his presence felt in a big way.
They've kept him under wraps all night long, but boy, did he find a great time to bust out.
Here's Levis. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's 2nd down. Under 90 seconds to go, here's 2nd and 10. Levis. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up 3rd down. Levis, he'll look to throw it. That's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted. And the Vikings have just about sewn up this football game. The disaster there, I mean, you saw it coming. The pressure gets knocked down, the interception.
Sometimes the best throw you make is the one you
don't make.
Exactly. Take care of the football. They'll also learn how to shrug your shoulders, take the proper slide steps to alleviate some of the pressure. But occasionally, like the one we just saw, sometimes just hold on to the football and take the hit.
They'll start on the ground here with Nwangu. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as it comes with 1:15 left to go in the 2nd half. And they're going to stop it right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. 2nd and 10. They'll fake it on the jet sweep, and instead a handoff up the middle. Now the Titans will use their 3rd and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. They'll set up the screen for Nwangu. Oh, nice move. And even though he gets out of bounds to stop the clock, it's not going to matter. That 1st down going to be enough to write a finish to this one. Probably the only thing he did wrong there was go out of bounds, nursing this 4th quarter lead. You want to stay in, eat the clock.
Yeah, you got to love the effort, the catch, the extra yardage, but you got to know the situation. Stay in bounds, young man.
Victory formation time for the Vikings as they'll take a knee here. Fields down to a knee here, and that should just about put a bow on this one.
Well, partner, it's just preseason, but it always feels good to be in victory formation, taking the knee for the W.
Yeah, I've often thought to myself when I watch these preseason games, some teams need the wins more than others. You know, if you're established and you're used to winning, not quite the same, but if you're trying to learn how to win, it's important to get it done. And to be able to kneel down at the end, even better.
Charles, in these lower scoring games, you know it better than anybody. Points are at such a premium, but taking care of the football is king. They play turnover free from whistle to whistle, and they come through with a victory.
Yeah, and that's what won them the game, because even doing it that way, being that clean partner, they weren't able to really run away with this game. So that tells us just how important it was to make sure you played mistake-free football that led.
This is the development trick. This is the abilities tab.
Man, I'm telling y'all I'm back. Heat urge in the stacks. Keep surging and max feel splurging. Living proof what you can have. Keep working, okay? People let it talk, they say whatever. Opinions change just like the weather. I got a question for whoever. Who do it better?
Sometimes they call me Dusifer. Talk about you do this and that. Ain't none of that the new to us. Acting like that you popped off. No damn well that you grew to us. Been in my own lane. Carry you like that dude the truck. Trend following. I'm surprised you just now catching up. It's my way or the highway, baby girl. I'm not a settler. Don't play with my kind. No matter my mind. I promise you get pitiful. They love me. They love me. I promise I do the bare minimum. My people, they say that I'm underrated, but it's crazy. I'm steady, they killing them. Can't ride my wave, I'm flipping them. Come up on some earth and I'm dipping them.
I'm so sick of all you. Weak, weak, lame, lame. Sick of being so mad, so happy, man. It's bad for that, man. It's 2023.
Final week of the preseason is here. A fourth exhibition game is a thing of the past. It's the Cardinals and the Vikings, and it's all up next.
A very warm day outside by Minnesota standards, but then again, it is still summer. Either way, the AC is working just fine at U.S. Bank Stadium in the Twin Cities. Today, it's a preseason matchup, as it'll be the Arizona Cardinals taking on the Minnesota Vikings. Brandon Gaudin and Charles Davis with you, and now we sit, CD, at week three of the preseason, and this is the one that the coaches probably think is pretty valuable, right?
Certainly. This is the dress rehearsal. This is the one where your starters are going to play. You might even game plan a little bit more than you do with a normal preseason game. And then you've got to decide, do you bring them back after halftime and get them going again in the third quarter? So
now the big leg of Matt Prater ready to get this one started. And we are underway from downtown Minneapolis. And the opening kickoff will not be returned, as that will be a touchback. So here's the Viking offense making their way out. They'll be led out by a first-round pick back in 2021 from Ohio State. It's Justin Fields.
And not only does he have all the skills that you're looking for as a quarterback, he's incredibly tough and plays the game fearlessly as both a runner and a passer. You provide a good running game around him and let him throw deep off of play action, you've got an all-star in the making.
And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. Here's a second and two now from the 33. Back to throw, Fields. Open man is Osborne, he's got it. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. From the gun, here's Fields. Gonna throw right side here, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. They get 14 there. First down, Vikings.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Now it's Fields off the bootleg. He's got a man wide open. It's Landry. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. He's been a one-man wrecking crew these last couple of plays. This time, 18 more and a first down. Well, they'll run it here on the jet sweep. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up.
No gain on the play. Second and 10.
Well, they'll run it here on the jet sweep. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29.
Defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, and one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
Being chased out left. Fields hit and the ball is loose. And the Cardinals have got it. Going the other way. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line. We know he's got the speed to get downfield, Charles, but there's the negative side, a little loose with the football that time.
And that's normal, especially when you have his type of talents, because you feel like you're into the open field, and maybe you don't feel the people who are around you or closing in. All quarterbacks have to do extra ball security drills with the way the game's played now, because defenses, they attack the football as much as they attack the runner.
Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their own 23. A short one there, caught by Swain. That'll go for a gain of 7, and it'll be second down. That was a lightning-fast decision that time. He just caught it and got rid of it.
Because he saw his guy was going to be open immediately, so he took the R, the run, out of the play. He took the O, the option, out of the play, and immediately got to the pass.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second-down throw that's knocked away and incomplete. Murray going to try to throw on third down. A short one here, caught by McBride. And he is going to have a Cardinals first down, although it doesn't appear to be by much. He needed 4, and he got 4 on third down. Now Murray. A short one there, caught by Swain. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. Second and 7. Murray gonna throw. He's got this downfield to McBride. Look at the big man rumble. Touchdown, Cardinals! Trey McBride, 64 yards. And the Cardinals use the early turnover to get on the board first here in this one. When they drew that up, I don't think they envisioned it ending in a house call, but he got it and took it all the way home.
Really impressive run after the catch, wasn't it? That was really special by him. But let's face it, in today's NFL, those tight ends are often former wide receivers or maybe even sometimes bigger running backs. They just put them in a position to get a great matchup and make plays like that.
Prater for the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25. The Vikings taking the field here for their second drive of the game. They had the fumble on the last drive, wound up leading to the opening touchdown. Now they'll try again here, first and 10. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Landry. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Good work after the catch. Gets him 15 and a first down. Well, starting drive number 2 off on the right foot. Completion for the first down. Drive 1 is they had to be pretty frustrating because they moved the football. They just didn't get any points out of it.
But warm-up QB 2, let's bring in the backup. I mean, my goodness, you take them downfield and you don't score points. You know I'm being totally facetious here, right? I'm just kidding. Nice first drive. Rarely do teams score on every single drive in a game. But they like what they did there. They just hope they can pay it off this time with some points.
4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle, and they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that, and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series, they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
He's a talented runner, and that means he's always looking for bigger and bigger gains when he takes off. Certainly found some bonus yards there beyond the first down marker, and this early drive will continue with that extra jolt from his legs.
After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. Second quarter now from Minnesota. It's the Vikings in possession of the football as they've got it with a first and 10. Fields. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
On the move to his left, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Tech McKinley made his way into the backfield.
And this is a quarterback who's already had success on the ground in this first half, but this time they're able to hem him in.
And it's always different when you rush a mobile quarterback as opposed to a guy you know will be right back in the pocket. In this case, you got to make sure the inside pressure and the outside pressure match, and maybe even a second wave to make sure if he squirts free, you've got someone to tackle him.
So the false start certainly doesn't help matters as they'll try again now, third and long. A shotgun snap, Fields. He's going to dump this off to his running. Oh, he's hit. He lost the football. Put it on the carpet. But this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same.
And while all of that was going on, we have an injured player out there in need of some attention. Well, injury's never good, especially here in the preseason. Hopefully nothing serious. They'll take a look at him, and we'll step aside for a moment.
Joseph's got it, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3.
So they are able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you have to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
So the Cardinals offense back onto the field here for their second drive of the game.
This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated. They both game planned for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete. These offensive starters still out there in the second quarter. You would think the plans for them to at least play into the third quarter, if not all the way through it.
Yeah, it might go by feel. If they have a really good first drive to start the third quarter, they might pull them after that. If not, might leave them out there a little bit longer, but I'll guarantee this, they'll be gone by the start of the fourth quarter. And this is what you want to see from a defense. Give up an opening drive touchdown, that's fine. But how about them going back out there, recommitting themselves to the task at hand, and forcing a 3-and-out and giving the ball back to their offense?
Landry now on the return. That's a 49-yard punt, 8 though on the return.
Minnesota's offense takes over possession.
And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just, I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10.
Now Fields.
And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. So from the 36 now, 1st and 10.
Fields now to throw.
Throw left side, taken in by Jefferson. And he'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6.
2nd down and 4. Again, Fields.
Another one on this play for Justin Jefferson. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another 1st down.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him, and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out, to the sideline, and make a catch.
And all the way down inside the 5 and the 4. The coverage may be too good that time as he breaks away for 19 with his legs and a 1st down.
2 minutes to play in this first half. 7-3, our score. To throw is Fields. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
You know, last week I remember asking you, what would an offensive coordinator be looking for week two of the preseason? Now we're in week three. Defensive coordinator-wise, what's he looking at?
For the most.
And it's caught in the end zone for a Viking touchdown by Justin Jefferson. 4 yards on the touchdown grab, and the Vikings have taken the lead. And all about timing there on that short slant, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
Greg Joseph on for the extra point. And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. So that drives 7 plays in length. And it was all capped off by Justin Jefferson's touchdown reception. Greg Dortch returning. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And Charles, a very uninspired effort. The last time we saw them out there was a quick 3-and-out, then they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never want to get stopped so soundly during a series, but what would be even worse now is letting it happen again right here. They've got to get going.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And he will lose yardage on the play, back at his own 19-yard line. Meanwhile, Murray's throw taken in by Pascal. The Vikings going to signal for their first of their timeouts, as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Buying time to his, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Now the Vikings will use the second of their timeouts, as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Now fair catch is called for and taken at the, we'll call it the 37-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt.
And it will be first and 10 as they take over.
So good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their 38.
Here's Fields. Swings this out for Hunt. And now they'll stop play here, at least momentarily. A member of the Vikings in some discomfort after that last play.
Boy, you hate to see this before the regular season even begins. We'll take a break and come back. More preseason action in a moment. Now it's Fields. Pass caught here by Osborne. So the completion good for 6 yards. And they'll be faced with a third and inches. Here's Fields. Work in the middle of the field. He's got a man complete. And he will have the Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
Right up to that point, I was about to say he's had a pretty good half catching the football, but let's just be honest about it. He should have caught that one.
And he knows that. That was one right in his breadbasket and one he normally catches.
We'll find Osborne here.
And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Cardinals 21.
This one caught by Osborne, right side.
And able to get this down inside the 15 to either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. It's a gain of 8. Brings up
second and 2. Looking to throw on second down, Fields.
And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down.
Throwing again is Fields.
And probably the wise decision there. No one open. He just throws it away. And that keeps the field goal on the table as it's fourth down. So they won't get a touchdown, but here's a chance to at least get 3 to end the first half. From the right hash, and this one just a chippy. The kick by Joseph is good, and the lead stretches to 6 here. It's 13-7.
Well, in a close game like this, obviously you want the touchdown, but certainly they will take the 3.
And they'll be okay with that. credit to the defense as well. I'm just glad this doesn't come down to a debate, right? Which side won, partner? Because the defense, hey, we didn't give up a touchdown. The offense, hey, we put three on the board. Either way you look at it, I think both sides gained something out of that drive.
So we've reached halftime here in Minnesota with the Vikings on top. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thank you very much. Week three of the preseason is here. Everyone wrapping up their exhibition schedule. No games for the league on Labor Day weekend. And then it all begins. The 17-game regular season gets underway on the Thursday after Labor Day with the NFL kickoff game. In our game, expect to see the starters for at least one more drive. Something to look forward to as we get you back out to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. This taken in at the goal line. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. The Cardinals ready to go here to start the third quarter. But Charles, we saw a pretty entertaining first half, close ball game. Remember there toward the end of the second quarter, the opposition scored to take the lead. Now we'll see if these guys can get a score of their own to regain that lead.
Yeah, they want to have that type of a response, don't they? Because they want to find a way to take control of this ball game one more time. Gauntlet's been thrown down. They want to see if they're ready to answer it.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
This defense has passed its first two tests by forcing back-to-back incompletions. They know there's probably another throw coming on third down. Let's see if they decide to force the issue by sending people on a blitz.
He'll set up the screen to Fournette. And he'll get this to the 23, but that'll be well short of what he needed. 5 yards, not enough, and it'll be fourth down.
And that's a play that's not uncommon on third and long because the offense is just hoping that somehow they can get a guy in space and follow some blockers downfield. Does a pretty nice job there getting a few yards, but he ends up getting stopped before he can get the first down.
It'll be a net of 39, 41-yard punt, 2 on the return. It's the Vikings' turn on offense. We get ready for their first possession of the second half. Now it's Fields off the bootleg. He's got a man wide open. It's Landry. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. Now we're going to get a stoppage here as we've got an injured Cardinal on the field. Well, injury's never good, especially here in the preseason. Hopefully nothing serious. They'll take a look at him, and we'll step aside for a moment. On first down, Fields. Looking for the out route. It's completed to Landry. In need of only about the length of the football here on second down. Jefferson going to go in motion right. He'll get it here on the jet sweep. And he stopped immediately there. Officially, it's no gain on the play, and they'll remain a few inches shy of a first with third down looming. Fields on third down. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. It's Zaven Collins who got in there to get the sack. So they dial up the blitz on third and inches. It pays off.
And frankly, they were probably dialing up a run blitz, expecting him to run it in that situation. But instead, they end up back at the quarterback and put him on the ground.
And this is good. It was running out of gas there at the end, but he winds up getting just enough on it. And now it's a two-score game at 9, 16-7. So the lead grows here incrementally, but I think the way their defense is playing, you feel okay with just getting three.
They've definitely been stout so far, but now that can all change because if one guy gets loose for 70 yards, this is a different game. But as it stands, field goals are good. Just keep adding to that lead.
Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. That is incomplete.
At this point in the game and the situation they're in, partner, these incompletions that we're seeing, they need to turn into positive snaps, and soon.
Now Murray throwing on second down. That's into the hands of Pascal. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Great way to convert on third down there, 21 yards the play.
And that's well executed there on third down, and I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
Throwing again, Murray. A good throw here, finding Pascal.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete.
He has just not had his focus in this game. It's not one drop. It's not two. That's three for this contest.
Yeah, uncharacteristic for any NFL receiver, and he's no exception. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings' 25-yard line. 18 yards, a big pickup there on third down. On first and 10, here's Murray.
A short one here, caught by McBride.
This will be a short gain of three before he's brought down at the 22.
Here's second and 7.
Inside handoff now to Fournette. And able to get about three as he's taken down right at the 20.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Murray now. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. Alexander Johnson, the one to drop him. And the attempt at three will have to come from the other end of the field as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more preseason football on EA Sports. And we return welcoming you back to Minneapolis. It's Cardinal football, but they trail here as we get set to bring you the fourth and final quarter. Prater's kick is good. And the deficit trend to 6 now at 16-10. All right, so they needed two scores to get back in the game. The field goal there, maybe not exactly what they wanted, but the necessary first step.
There's still time remaining, and there's enough time to get it done. They've got to get at the least a three.